Zero-based index, I'm the fifth one. So, it's going to be really quick. Just quick show of hands. How are you guys managing, and girls, how are you guys and girls managing styles in your Ember application? Exactly. So if you take a look at Ember Observer, there's, for example, Ember CLI Test, which I think pretty much of you have used. Quick show of hands. Yeah, that's what I thought. So the problem with Ember CLI, what?
Tailwind.
Tailwind is also nice. There's a great video series on Ember Map. You should watch it. The problem with Ember CLI SAS, or SAS in general for me, is that most people probably do something like BEM, and they abuse BEM in that they do it to the max, and you nest and nest and keep on nesting, and then in the end you have class names which look like this, and you go, what the fuck? Exactly, that's why you have UX developers. And in order to help UX developers, there's, in my opinion, an amazing add-on, which is called Ember CSS Modules. Some of you may have heard about it. It's this repository, made by the wonderful Dan Freeman. And I will just quickly show you what you can do with it. So instead of going class, you just write local class. And then you have a style file, which is directly co-located to the template that is invoking the local class. And you just write regular CSS as you would, but you get some superpowers, like you can use composers to compose different classes from different files. For example, here we are loading a general typo file, and we are composing the heading class, which is why in the template you can see that it's actually colored and inheriting the styles from there. And you can also use it on components with decorators, like local class names. And yeah, that's about it. Check it out. Thank you very much.